It's there for a reason, because you're different than everybody else. But you're different, but you're made to function together, just like our body has different parts. They're way different, man. My colon is way different than my eyeball. But my eyeball is counting on my colon to send some nutrients up there. It's counting on my brain to drink water so my eyeball stays moist. And so that same principle applies to us. Jesus says that. We're all one body. So you might not think that, well, me coming to church, I don't know where I go, you know. But you're part of the body. You've got something to offer.
So true.
So we're going to watch a video by Joyce Myers. I love Joyce Myers. I never thought I would look up to female pastors and leaders, especially when I was a younger guy, arrogant, full of myself. But then I fell terribly, and Jesus picked me up. But from that humiliating experience, I'm able to appreciate and love people. Doesn't matter who you are, doesn't matter what you've done. Sean experienced this too. That hate that you had in your heart, God now turns that into love for other people. It's amazing. And so Joyce Myers is going to talk about faith. And so we're going to watch it. It's only 30 minutes long. And then I'm going to come back and talk about faith. Because we all have different stuff we're struggling with. Some of us are struggling with finances, some of us with relationships, some of us with health problems. Like, there's all kinds of different stuff in the room. But there's always one answer, and his name is Jesus. And sometimes we try to work too hard to fix the problem when we should be letting Jesus work to fix the problem.
Yes.
Now, sometimes Jesus will ask you to do something that's a key to your problem. Remember, I talked. Because Jesus will whisper something in your ear. And it might be a hard thing, it might be an easy thing, but it'll be a thing of following him. And when we follow him, he will take us to that place where we need to be, because he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So we're going to watch this video. Joyce is going to talk about some different stuff, about faith, forgiveness, and some other stuff, and she's going to give some examples. And so if you're a really mature Christian and you've heard about 1,000 messages, you may say, oh, that's beginner stuff. Humble yourself before the Lord and receive a message, okay? And if you're a newbie Christian, you might say, wow, that's way over my head. I don't get what this lady's talking about. After the service, we're going to pray. There's going to be a couple of us up here, and if you want prayer, we'd love to pray for you. But this message is going to be about faith. And it's going to be about trusting Jesus. And trusting Jesus is like, well, is that faith? Is that belief? Do I believe? Like, what is faith? So she's going to touch on some of this stuff. But I think the hardest thing to do with regards to faith is trust. You know? Is trust. Lord, I'm out of work, and if I don't do this, and you know, trust me. Lord, I'm in this relationship and I just feel trapped and, you know, I should, you know, I'm going to leave and, you know, there's all these different questions. Should I leave? Should I stay? You know what I mean? But God is whispering answers to us. If we'll listen. Because sometimes we'll go to Facebook to get our answers. Sometimes we'll go to CNN to get our answers. Sometimes we'll go to Wikipedia to get our answers. You know what I mean? But the one that is whispering to us, that is the answer. And so I'm going to ask Kyle to hit the lights and James to cue up the video. Lord, I just pray a blessing on this video by Joyce, Lord. She loves you so much and she's been through so much. And the stuff that she's been through, Lord, she's going to share with us so that she can bless us. And just prepare our hearts to receive it now in Jesus' name.
Okay. Check. James is hugging it out, and he's got to turn my mic off.
Thank you. Thank you, James. Okay. So we just watched Joyce Myers talk about faith. And she said a bunch of stuff in there that kind of spoke to me, too, because I've been walking this out for a while now. And I want to show you something for a minute here. Margaret and Sean will be active participants in this.
Yeah.
Margaret, come on up. This is Margaret. I love Margaret. I'm so glad she's part of our church.
Go, Margaret.
Amen.
Go, Margaret.
Now, Margaret has family members who do not know Jesus. But Margaret knows Jesus. And she knows this awesome thing that God has done for her. I mean, God just changed her life from the inside out. Now, when God does that for you, you have this burning desire to help other people who you see are suffering. The problem is, they don't know they're suffering. Some of them know they're suffering, right? But some of them haven't come to the sobriety yet that they're suffering. They haven't released the revelation of it. So Dave, for example, knew that he was incredibly overweight. And he knew it for a while. But there had to be something in him that clicked, that understood that he wasn't content to stay that way anymore. And that took him on a journey. Now, what happens is Margaret over here is praying for her family. Because there's members of her family that are suffering. And they don't really know it yet. Because they haven't experienced the fullness or freedom in Jesus Christ. And so here's Margaret praying. Now, Sean is part of Margaret's life. Sean is this wild, crazy, angry, drugs, partying it up, tell God to blank off. I don't want no part of it. Now, is that intimidating to Margaret? Yes, it is. That's intimidating. Or if we see one of our loved ones who's out there and they're drug addicted and they're in let's say they're a prostitute or in the pornography industry, and that thing just looks so big, you say, oh God, they're suffering, they don't know it, what can I do? Does this praying thing even work? Because I don't see the results. The results that I go to McDonald's, I say, Big Mac combo, root beer and a taco. Okay, pull up please, it'll be $7.50. And then you get it, right? But what you don't see is the process that is happening in the kitchen, because the manager had to order the food, they had to get in the freezer, and they had to prep it, and they had to anticipate for volume and all that stuff. So all this stuff is going on.
Yeah.
Well, when Margaret starts praying, all this stuff starts going on in the atmosphere. God starts working on Margaret's behalf, but she can't see it. Sean is still this evil, hating, angry, want to kill somebody guy. Right? Now, if you didn't know Sean before, it's hard to perceive that, because he's just this lovely, cuddly guy that's loving on people, man. Oh, man, you just need some love from Jesus, man. Come on! He wasn't like that before. So this looks impossible. But Margaret says, I'm going to pray. And you know what her faith level was? It was probably smaller.
I had no other choice.
But to trust God. I had no other choice. Lost cause. Still pray. God started working. Sean got saved. Never ever thought it would happen. Maybe just this little glimmer of something. I want to ask Margaret, now I want you to answer honestly.
Yeah.
While you were praying, could you have imagined this outcome?
Honestly, no. I loved him no matter what. And I think love is what changes everything. It's easier to hate, but you gotta love them. You gotta love everybody, right?
Hallelujah.
Now, were you satisfied with his lifestyle?
No, I remember one time, is it okay if I share about
Okay,
so I was babysitting and I was at his house and I was sleeping in the den, and he was in the bathroom, he had gone out drinking, and I woke up and heard him suffering, and he was really thrown out bad. Like it was, you know, it sounded really painful, and so I was kind of led to tears and praying for him, and I just didn't want him to die, right? Because it just seems so, even though you think you're having fun when you're drinking a lot, you know. So that's what I did. I just prayed, and he didn't know it. I didn't tell him.
So. But you probably would have just been happy with, hey, I prayed a sinner's prayer. I'm saved. You couldn't imagine this.
I didn't want him to go to hell. Didn't want him to go to hell.
So,
right, yeah.
I'm didn't want him to go to hell. God doesn't want you to go to hell. Hell's not made for you. Hell's made for Satan. But Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. If I follow a school bus, I'm going to end up at school.
Yes.
If I follow a garbage truck, I'm going to end up at the dump. And so that's the choice that we make. Jesus, I'm going to follow you. Or Satan, I'm going to follow you. Real simple, black and white. But once you've received the forgiveness of Jesus, life is good. All that guilt and anger and rage and all that stuff that you had, it's now gone. But she talked about a process. You see, there's a process that happens. You know, we expect, boom, our life is totally different, and it is. But there's still some junk that we've been carrying on that we haven't fully surrendered yet to God. And so now there's a faith issue. You know, you're praying for a loved one, and like she said, you're trying to manipulate them, control them, and, you know, all this different stuff. But she said, trust me. God says, trust me. Will you give that to me? I'll deal with that. And while I deal with that, I wrote some love letters for you I'd like you to look at. And so, Tim is a mechanic. When you first become a mechanic, you don't know everything. You think you know everything. But you have to go back to the manual and go, okay, that's what it looks like, that's what this says, that's what that. I'm going to need that wrench. Oh, I don't have that gasket. I got to get a new gasket. Do you know what I mean? And that's what happens with our walk with God. We get this moment of sobriety and we need Jesus, right? And he comes in and he does it. But then we have to walk it out. Then it's the process. Then it's the faith thing. Oh God, I trust you with my loved one. Oh God, I trust you with my finances. Oh God, I trust you with my relationships. But that trusting part is trusting that what he said he will do, and when he says, here's the way I want you to do it, that's the way we should do it. Because what she said, when we try to do it our own way, we mess it up. If James builds a foundation, he's a construction dude. If he builds a foundation, sometimes God will say, James, you know that sub wall or whatever you built? Yeah. Will you go walk on it for a minute? Ooh, okay. Goes, walks on. Whoa! The bricks start falling out.
Fire.
And he's like, God, what's going on here? You told me to... God was trying to show James that he didn't use the right mortar mix. And those bricks fell out. But God was merciful to James. And he showed him that before James built the rest of the house. Because if he would have built the rest of the house, the whole thing would have collapsed and it would have been devastating to everybody. And so we get this thing with Jesus, and what happens is we make mistakes down the road. And Jesus says, that's okay. I forgive you, but now I want you to come and follow me because I've got a better way of doing things.
Amen.
And we're going to build that house, which is your life, and it's going to be really good.
Yeah.
But like Joyce was saying, we got to trust him. And sometimes that means releasing something that we've been holding on to so tightly. Because we want to do it our way. And God's saying, will you give that to me so I can give you something better? Maybe you're you're in an awful relationship, and God is saying, will you give that to me so I can give you something better? Or we're holding on to our finances so tightly and we're stingy because we're just, oh God, how are you ever going to give me money if I don't let go a little bit of this? And God says, will you give me that little bit so I can give you a lot? Because I was going through that this week, faith. I'm struggling with God because I've been unemployed for a while. And I'm like, God, how are you ever going to do this? I'm so tired. God, help me, please. How much longer, you know? And God's okay with you doing that with your heart. He's a good dad. You can pour that out to him. But then that mustard seed started to shake and it started to grow a little bit. And he said, Mark, remember when I bailed you out of that? Oh, yeah. Mark, remember when I did that? Oh, yeah, you did. I remember when I did that, and it was unexplainable. And I'm like, oh, you're worthy. You're worthy. I trust you, God. And what did Joyce say? Because our emotions will betray us. Our emotions will say, yeah, that boy will leave me unless I have sex with him. Our emotions will betray us. God says, no, date that boy, take him to church, tell him about Jesus, and I'll give you a good, healthy relationship. Why? Because God said, I want you to do it a certain way because I want something really good for you. It's like Joyce said about, I want to take you out and buy you new shoes. I don't think I'm ever going to get new shoes. Look at these lousy shoes. But God's saying, I love you. I want to give you new shoes. I can't wait another day. I'm dying. Ever have that? You can be real. You can be mad at me, guys. It's okay. If I'm stepping on some toes, it's okay. You know why? Because I got my toes stepped on so many times, I don't feel it anymore. Because God was trying to humble me, and I was too proud and arrogant to listen, and I said, I'm going to do it my way, God. And you know what I reaped in my life? Brutal. Brutal, brutal. Got fired from my job. Lost my house. My wife was leaving me. You still want to do it your way, Mark? Big shot? Brutal, Sean. Brutal. 1997. God totally saved my life. So I know what I'm talking about. I've been through some stuff. I'm going through some stuff now. But then I had to remind myself, oh yeah, you saved my marriage. Oh yeah, you gave me a house. A beautiful house. Got a daughter, I got a car. Got all this stuff. Don't have a job. I've got a second interview on Tuesday in Burlington.
Okay.
And you got us.
And I've got my church family. Let me tell you what, like Devon was saying, you know, he's got church family that loves him no matter what. It's part of what church is for. We love you. So Joyce was saying, have faith in God. And God says, here, I'll show you a way. I said, okay, God, I'll do it your way, because my way sucks. And Margaret now sees the result in Sean. Sean talked to little Dave.
Yeah.
Little Dave talked to his family. You know, talked to Tim. Tim's here. And so now we have this domino effect of all these people's lives are being changed. But when Margaret was praying, listening to Sean puke his guts out in the bathroom, didn't look like much hope then. So what's this message today about? It's about trusting God.
Yeah.
It's about doing it His way. And so now I'll end with this. Jesus is about to go to the cross, and He knows it. But he's got these disciples that have been hanging out with him for the last 3 years. And they've seen all these crazy miracles and stuff like that. And he knows he's about to leave them. And he knows that they're going to see him die on the cross. And when your hero and your leader is whipped, he surrendered all his authority. Did you know that when the soldiers went to get Jesus, and they said, who are you? And he said, I am Jesus. They all fell down. Did you know that? Read your Bible. They had no authority to hang Jesus on that cross because all Jesus did was good. He went around healing people, doing good, but they wanted to kill him for it. And he had the authority not to go to the cross, but he surrendered his authority to go to the cross because he had you in mind.
Thank you, Jesus.
Man, that's good news. That surrendering that occurs. I trust you. I'm going to surrender what I think is right in exchange for what you think is right. And it's like you get a blood transfusion. And so Jesus is about to leave these guys, and he's like, ugh. You know, it's like sending your kids off to camp. Renee and I did that. We sent our daughter off for camp. We were crying more than she was crying, right? Because we didn't know what was going to happen. We're not going to be connected for the next week. If you have kids, you know what I'm talking about, right? So we send her off to camp. And so Jesus is saying, I'm going to leave these guys, and I need them to be okay. Because they don't know what's going to happen. So let's read this again, John 14. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going there to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said, Lord, we don't know where you're going. Remember what that little boy said this morning? Yeah, come. Where? His disciples are saying that too. Where are you going, Jesus? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. It's all about Jesus. It's all about trusting him. It's all about trusting him. Just like Joyce said, whatever you're going through, give it to God and do it his way, because he has something better for you than what you're currently experiencing in your life. And it'll take a little bit of trust. It's like that chair Joy said, right? It's going to take a little bit of trust. If you could see the chair, oh, I don't have to trust in it, right? I see it. It's well made. It's good, you know? But trusting in something that you can't see. Jesus said when he rose again from the dead and he was with the disciples, he said, remember doubting Thomas? Well, until I put my, finger in his hand and, the spear, put my hand in there, I'm not going to believe. You know what Jesus said? Blessed are those who believe that haven't seen. That's us. He said, blessed are you guys, because all you're going to have to go on is this and my Holy Spirit. Remember what we sang this morning with Bob? It's that Holy Spirit. Let's pray. Josh. Lord, we thank you for that awesome word today from Joyce Myers. To trust in you. To follow you. To listen to that small voice that you're whispering to us. To follow you. And to put our trust in you. And for every person here, Lord, who's struggling with something that they need to trust you about, I just pray that you minister to them, Lord. And just like Margaret when she was praying, to pray and to trust, Lord, that you'll take it and that you'll do something good with it, Lord. We all struggle, God. But you said in your word, when we are weak, you are strong. You are strong when we are weak. And so, Lord, we confess that we're weak and we struggle and we need you. We need you, Jesus. 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 With everybody's eyes closed, if you don't know Jesus right now, but you want to know Jesus, and you know that you really need Jesus, can you just raise your hand? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that you never ever reject us. You always receive us. And you always hear that prayer, help me, Jesus, I need you. Help me, Jesus, I need you. Let's stand for a minute. Bob's got a song for us. And then we're going to let you go after the song. We've got some refreshments in the back. But if you need prayer this morning, and if you prayed that prayer, Jesus, I need you, there's going to be a couple of us up at the front. We'd love to pray for you.
Till you come and see.